probably know the saying, you are what you eat. But what about you think what you eat? We're going to explain. The gut isn't just helpful in keeping us physically healthy. It also plays a really key role in managing mental well-being. So I want to bring in Dr. Uma Naidoo to discuss the surprising connection between the brain and the gut. She's a nutritional psychiatrist and the author of the book, This Is Your Brain on Food. This is so fascinating because this whole idea of sort of the brain in your gut and the biome in your gut, you know, it used to be kind of like alternative medicine, alternative thinking, but increasingly more and more is become a mainstream medical conversation. So can we talk about the connection between your gut and your brain?
Thanks so much, Anne-Marie. It's great to talk to you today. You know, the gut and brain is really new burgeoning scientific work that's come out over the last couple of decades, although Hippocrates eons ago spoke about it. But what we understand is that the gut and brain arise from the exact same cells in the human embryo. And so they are connected even from our early development. And then they are connected by the vagus nerve throughout our lives. And I'd like to think of the vagus nerve, which is our 10th cranial nerve, as a text messaging system between the brain and the gut, sending messages all the time that is communicating chemical messages. And one of the things that affects these chemical messages is the food that we eat. So the gut microbes interact with the food that we eat. And on days that we're eating, you know, those healthier foods, they are nurturing and taking care of the good microbes in the gut. But on days that we're kind of heading to the standard American diet of processed, ultra-processed, and fast foods, the bad microbes are taken care of. And that upsets the balance in the gut, leading to conditions like inflammation or dysbiosis. So it's a very important connection that actually explains the food-mood connection.
Mm-hmm. And we're talking about, you know, people think, oh, yeah, my gut always talks to me. It tells me that I'm hungry. We're talking about not just messaging like that, like you're full or you're not full, which is a whole other conversation, but other things about our mental well-being. So then how do we make sure that our gut is healthy so that our mind is healthy? Mm. What should we be eating?
That's a great question because honestly, Anne-Marie, nutritional psychiatry is about filling that gap of helping people understand this food-mood connection. And many people talk about food in terms of their waistline or, you know, family history of hypertension, but they don't think about their brain and their mind. One of the best things you can do is clean up your diet a little bit. Start off with fiber, extremely important for the gut microbes because that's what helps them thrive. And guess what? You can get fiber from elements of the Mediterranean diet or just a good, healthy diet with lots of plant-rich foods, vegetables, beans, nuts, seeds, legumes, healthy whole grains. You can't actually get fiber from animal sources of protein, so lean into those veggies. But then you also want clean proteins in your diet, and you want healthy fats from things like omega-3 fats. And if you're plant-based, you can get a short-chain omega-3s from chia seeds and flax seeds and things like that. So it's really trying to clean up our diet from that standard American diet called SAD for a reason. And, you know, cutting back on processed foods and leaning into healthy whole foods. I like to tell people, you know, think about eating the whole orange. Skip the store-bought orange juice, which has a ton of added sugars.
Really quickly, supplements, yes or no? Because there's a whole category now dedicated to this.
Right. The role for supplements in brain health, especially for the nutritional gaps that we can't fill. B vitamins, if you are short on B vitamins or depending on your diet, B complex vitamins, great for your brain health. Saffron, a great supplement for mood, and speak to your doctor, of course, about the supplement. But there are definitely different ones that can fill in nutritional gaps. So there is a place for supplements. But it's something that is a careful consideration, but always food first. Because, you know, the power's at the end of our fork. We can make a decision at every meal to improve our brain health.
A lot cheaper than a supplement. Dr. Naidoo, thank you very much.
Thank you.
This program is brought to you in part by Rinvoq.